Hi kids, and welcome to Almost VeggieTales. I'm kind of Bob the Tomato.
And I'm sort of Larry the Cucumber.
And we're here to answer your questions. So let's pray and then get into your letters. Father God, thank you so much for today. Thank you for loving us and making us unique and being so special to you that no matter who we are, no matter where we are, you are always watching over us. God, thank you for the week. Thank you for your word, the Bible. Help us to read it, to be in a relationship with you. It's not just about knowing you and who you are and the stories of the Bible, but it's about knowing you in our hearts and walking beside you and getting to be closer to you each and every day. So Father, help us to do that. Help us to learn your word. And help us to remember just how special we are to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Okay, so Larry, did we get any letters this past week?
We sure did, Bob. The rain or snow or sleet or melting temperatures like we had this last week, the mail still got through. The first letter we got is from Bradley Wallander of Three Hills, Alberta. He writes, "Dear Bob and Larry, so I've always eaten my fruits, and I do try to eat my vegetables at every meal. I don't mean to boast or anything, but in my short 6 years on Earth, I estimate I'm running a solid 83% to 84% intake rate. Granted, my first year was around 100% when everything put on the spoon, including mushed peas, went in my mouth. Given these years of vegetation intake, it never occurred to me that I might be eating your relatives. I mean, poor Madame Blueberry, untold. Even as I write this, my little eyes well up with tiny tears. If I had only realized sooner, I would have eaten only bacon. I never refuse bacon. It's a carnivore's life for me from now on. Oh, the vegetarianity! Oh, Laura, so many carrots.
Oh, Bradley, no! Don't worry. Everything you've eaten is completely edible. We are unique in that we are able to speak and dance and sing. Yes, Larry, I can sing and dance. So don't stop eating your fruits and veggies.
Yeah, Bradley, if you're ever worried, feel free to talk to your food. If it talks back, then give us a call. Maybe you'll fit them on the show.
Right. Just make sure others can hear them as well, okay, Bradley? So, Larry, do we have another letter?
Yeah, Bob. This one is from Huck Blackberry of Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. Oh, I love blackberries.
The fruit or the foam?
Huh? Foam?
Well, the Blackberry Foam was a major foam company in Canada, rivaling
Bob,
many
there are two real foams, the iPhone and the Galaxy. We feel for the few that have Windows or Google ones, but Blackberry, you're really dating yourself.
Wait a minute, Larry. You're as old as I am.
I try to live in the moment. It doesn't show my age like you do.
Okay, fine. But you were reading out the letter from Huck before you decided to pretend that you never knew about the Blackberry phone.
You're right. Let's get back to the letter. Huck writes, "Dear Bob and Larry, I need your help. I was lying in my bed and I was feeling kind of sleepy, but I couldn't close my eyes. The room was getting creepy. I was sure I saw Bibles in the closet and Godzilla in the hall, and there was something being buried casting shadows on the wall. And then my heart started to beat like a drum, and my skin got kind of clammy. And that's when 100 shiny monsters started to jump right into my jammies. What am I gonna do? What are you gonna do? You're gonna call the police."
No, Huck doesn't need to do anything.
What? Why?
Because God is bigger than the boogeyman. He's bigger than Godzilla or the monsters on TV. And he's watching out for you. Listen, Huck, when Jesus went up against Satan himself, he had on the full armor of God, and he wasn't afraid. When Satan tried to attack him, Jesus answered with the word of God, the words of the Bible. The sword of the Spirit. They were in his heart and he believed them. We are all afraid at times, and that's okay. He can help us realize that something isn't right, or we may be in trouble and need to get a trusted grown-up. But we also need to remember that God is watching over us all the time.
That's right, Bob. God says that He never leaves us or abandons us, and God never lies.
And we can always pray wherever and whenever, and God will always hear us. So you see, Huck, being afraid is okay, though God also tells us a lot in the Bible about not being afraid, because He wants us to trust and focus on Him. He has given all believers a helper, the Holy Spirit, to strengthen us. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7 says, "For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind."
Exactly. God wants us to lean on Him for support whenever we need it. So remember, God made you special and He loves you very much.
Bye-bye. So didn't you ever have a BlackBerry?
I had a Nokia. It was great for crushing walnuts.